Hi, in this video I'm going to explain Reservation Aloha, which is also known as R Aloha. R Aloha actually, this is a protocol of demand assigned multiple access. We can divide all protocol into two categories: permanently assigned multiple access, which is known as PAMA, and another category, demand assigned multiple access. So in permanent assigned multiple access, once a channel capacity is assigned to a user, now that user will use that capacity forever. The example, we can take FDMA. So in FDMA, our channel is divided into sub channel, and every sub channel will be assigned to a particular user. Now doesn't matter that particular user is using that channel or not, that channel cannot be used by other user. Another category, which is also known as DAMA, demand assigned multiple access, that category says channel capacity or resource will not be assigned to a user until unless it is required. So when a user want to send data through a channel, in that case that user need the channel. So channel capacity will be assigned to user on demand dynamically. Once the user is done with transmission, that channel capacity will be returned to the we can say pool, resource pool. So here R Aloha, it actually use two type of modes. One mode is unreserved, another mode is reserved. So in order to reserve some time slot, like a user two, we are having here three users: user one, user two, user three. So three users want to send some data, so before sending data they have to reserve time slots, how many time slots they want. And what is the way to reserve a time slots? In R Aloha there are some short time slots, and in this time slot these user can transmit very small reservation request. So this reservation request actually sent using slotted Aloha protocol. So if a user is successfully transmitted that request in that short time slot, he will receive acknowledgement, and that acknowledgement actually having information which time slot, which data time slot is reserved for that user. So we are going to show all that process using this animation here. So let's start the process. So here if you can see these time slots, if you can see these are the empty time slots. So these time slots are used to reserve these slots. So these are the data slots in which user will transmit data, and these short time slots are used to reserve these data. Now in these short time slot, user will try to send their reservation request, and this one is done using slotted Aloha. So in slotted Aloha, every user can transmit only in the beginning of slot. So these are the slots, in the beginning a user can transmit. Now it might be possible that two users send reservation request in single slot, so in that case collision will be there and that request will not be considered. So here this green is representing that in this slot user one successfully sent its reservation request, he received acknowledgement, and a data slot is reserved for user one, and this reservation list actually sent to every user, so every other user would know that this time slot is already reserved. Now if you will see some more, so here we are seeing there are some small short time slots. So here blue representing user 2 successfully transmitted its reservation request, so one time slot will be reserved for user 2, and so on. So here if you can see, first slot user 1 reserved, user 1 transmitted its reservation request. So these time slots actually used to send request, so user actually conveying this message that I want to use channel. So here user 1 has sent, then user 2 has sent, and then user 3 has sent the request. And so corresponding, they assigned the time slots. So user 1 assigned 1 data slot, user 2 assigned 2 data slot, and user 3 assigned 3 data slot. So these data slot transmission in these slots are contention free. There won't be any collision. But in reservation, there will be collision. So this is the contention based. Why? Because slotted aloha is used here and here. Simply every slot will be reserved according to these slot time slots. And if a slot reserved for user 1, only user 1 will transmit in that channel. So if we see again here, here user 2 transmitted, user 3 transmitted, so they got a 1-1 time slot. So this number of time slot can vary. A user when sent a reservation request, that user can specify how many time slot he needs. So this transmission will go on. So at the end, I want to brief this protocol. R Aloha, this is a demand assigned multiple access protocol, DAMA. This protocol says that when a user need resource, only at that time it will be assigned. Once work is done, it will be taken back. So assignment will not be permanent. Second thing, R Aloha protocol use two mode of transmission. One mode is reserved mode, another mode is unreserved mode. So unreserved mode is actually used for reserving time slots. So in unreserved mode, slotted Aloha protocol is used. Every user send its reservation request. So if a user successfully send its reservation request, he will also get the information about time slot reserved for that user, and that time slot list will be shared with every node. So every node will be having idea which time slot reserved for which node. And so this data, the slot in which data is sent by users, are contention free. There won't be any collision, but it might be possible that in unreserved mode or slotted Aloha protocol here, if you can see here in this short time slot, collision are possible. So this will be continue like this one. So thank you very much for watching this video.